So please put your hands together one more time and let's invite on stage Mr. Nayan Shah.
Our chief guest, Dhananjay ji, my leading friends, Subhash bhai, my architect, the first architect with whom I worked in my life, friends from NAR, and dignitaries from the industry. Just like to share a few thoughts with you as to what's actually happening in the Mumbai real estate industry today. I'm very closely associated with CREDAI, and just want to put a disclaimer that these are strictly my personal views and no views of CREDAI or any of the organizations I represent. If you actually see that in the last 8 months, demonetization, RERA, GST, 3 to 4 orders of the High Court, dumping ground for Mumbai, water order for Thane, the environmental orders from the National Green Tribunal, the environmental orders from the Supreme Court, the orders given by Maharera in so many cases. So this is the external environment with which we are passing to today. While the DCR Mumbai 2034 is under its final stages, the government has issued various notifications, you call the road width policy, the TDR policy, the accommodation reservation policy, and again on 16 November 2016 we had the road width policy by which all developments less than 9 meters were deemed to be state. So on one hand, we have a very vigilant government which is trying to straighten the industry and which is trying to decentralize all the powers, all the approvals, doing ease of business a reality. But at the other side, what's the reality for us? In this audience today are estate agents, developer, architects, professionals from like Pramod is here, and you know all the. So this hall represents nothing but a sample of the industry today. The reality is, number one, costs are rising. Sand is an issue, metal is an issue, cement cartelization. The government just announced that the fuel prices, they will not be decontrolling, so labor, transport, everything is going to go up. Cost of approvals have gone up. Developers and everybody connected in the industry today is in a cash flow trap. He is in an interest overhead trap. He is in a debt trap. He is in a time trap. He is on a regulatory trap. And in order to meet this difficulty, some of the developers, even myself, for my ready projects, I have reduced my prices by 10%, 15%, 20%. Bhai, maal bikna chahiye. Kyunki maal bikega nahi, paisa aayega nahi, to byaj kahan chukaunga, pagar kahan se dunga. Whatever new projects I have reduced my prices. I am giving interest subvention. I am giving all kinds of facilities. And I am saying that, jab tak main OC nahi deta hun, paisa mat dena, abhi 5% deke khali, aap stamp duty registration kara lo, taki main mere banker ko keh saku ki maine itne rupaye ka sale lock kar diya. So on and so forth, everybody is trying to survive. Everybody is trying to see, ki I'm able to meet the liabilities for the next quarter. Cost of approvals have gone up, because everything is linked to ready reckoner. In Thane, there are some pockets where the actual sale price is lesser than the ready reckoner. So, on one side, we have a very proactive government that wants to really straighten the industry. And on one side, we have the real difficulties that we are facing. I honestly don't know as to where all this is leading to. If the ready stocks, somebody is willing to sell at 15, 20, 10% discount, give margins of 8 to 10% on sales and marketing expenses, if somebody is willing to sell his under construction flats at a discount, then ultimately, what is the net worth that will be left with the developer or by the stakeholder? So this is one side of the situation, and honestly, I don't have any answers. I mean, I just requested Sapna that I would like to share these thoughts at the beginning of this conclave. So, you know, as and when we are having our tea or when the panelists come up here, we each of us can tell their own story as to how they are surviving or how they are, what kind of idea they have to, you know, to come out of it. But there is one ray of hope, is that all our projects now are registered under MAHARERA. The outer limit of the completion of our projects are known to us. Whatever project I have registered under RERA, I have to announce what is the date of the completion. I think one thing that we would like to request to the government and would request reality or the press, you know, to take it up is that why don't they become a little bit more proactive? I am not at all complaining about the rates of real estate. Let the market decide. Jio came and it destabilized Vodafone and everybody. That's the market force. So if the market is going down, so be it. I may lose money, so be it, no problem. But because of the delay in environment or a court stay order or reasons beyond my control, if my project gets delayed and I get into a debt trap, then that is one situation which is going to pull down the entire industry together. So I have three requests before the government. Number one, that time-bound approvals at all level, whether it is civil aviation, defense, railways, heritage, or whatever, at the central level. Time-bound approvals at the state level, so whether it's MOEF, whatever, the state has to give revenue, subdivision, amalgamations, so on and so forth. And time-bound approvals at the local level. So this is the first request, Sapna. Time-bound approvals at all the three levels. How they come together and do it is not my problem. Because unless they don't do this, this industry is going to see some very bad days. Two, the government of Maharashtra needs to come out and tell the courts that looking at the urbanization that is going to happen in the MMR, in Thane, Vasai, Virar, Palghar, Navi Mumbai, Mumbai, that we are going to take care of the 12 crore people that live in MMR and we are going to provide them adequate water, adequate sewer, adequate facility for dumping ground, so on and so forth. So that the environmentalists, which are concerned for the life of you and me and the life of our children or grandchildren, they are doing a great job, that the courts are satisfied that the government has the entire infrastructure, connectivity, quality of life properly laid out before them, and they are going to roll that out in 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 7 years. So that's the second thing, that the government needs to really come up and tell the courts so that these kind of stays that suddenly come up, you know, and stop a 1,000 crore project, that wouldn't happen. Point number two. And point number three, there is a tremendous cement cartelization going on, RMC cost. I mean, some of you who are there, they know that almost 20 to 30 to 40% has been the increase in the RMC cost. Today, we are not able to get quality sand, quality metal. Even that is also controlled by a few groups in MMR. All of us know, sab jante kaun hai, but koi naam nahi dena chahta hai. So these are the three requests that we have for the government. And if they can come and anchor this, then I tell you, this industry can become one of the greatest industries of India and can become the greatest growth center for the next 10 to 20 to 30 years. This is the basic thing that I wanted to share with all of you. And the last thing that I want to share with all of you is that I hope one day a builder or an architect or anybody connected to the real estate industry becomes the chief minister of Maharashtra or becomes the prime minister of India. Then only the affordable housing will actually become a reality. This is the last wish that I have. Thank you.